Starting off this episode, we're going to recap the OMFL championship action. Junior Varsity losing again to the only team that they lost to all season, the Orangeville Outlaws. Orangeville takes the crown, winning 41-17. Varsity, on the other hand, beating the Outlaws, finishing off their season 10-0, perfect record. They win that game and the championship by a score of 35-14. So congratulations to both the Junior Varsity and Varsity teams on great seasons. A special congratulations is in order to one of our JV OMFL players. Kristen Carrier was recruited by the Central Ontario Women's Football League following the championship game in Orangeville. So congratulations, Kristen, and we wish you the best in the future. OVFL JV playoff action. Cambridge versus Brampton Bulldogs. First play of the game here, Cambridge kicks off to Brampton. Nana Asubontang getting some great leading blocks. He's going to run that one back for a touchdown for Brampton's first play of this game. Brampton up 6-0. And the very next play, Cambridge getting the kick return from Brampton. They run it ahead a couple yards. They'll start off from about their own 35. Very next play, Jackson White, he gets this ball. He's going to go deep to Hudson. Hudson breaking off from the tackle. He's gone home free. Cambridge leads 7-6, and not even a minute has gone by in this game yet. Early stages of the second quarter now. Brampton in striking distance. Malcolm Miller's going to take this ball and run it to the outside. He'll find the end zone. Brampton now leading 12-10. Then a few minutes later, Nathan McLean putting another big field goal up on the board. Cambridge leading 13-12. Just under the halfway point in the second quarter now. Javonte Stanley going deep over the middle to Jamal Kruma. He climbs a ladder to grab that. Runs it into the end zone. Brampton now leading 19-13. And check this out. The ref's shoe making an appearance at the end of that play. A few plays later, Cambridge deep in their own end. Get this one started. Jackson White calling his own number. He takes a licking and ends up on the bottom of the dog pile. Picks up some good yards for Cambridge. Then Jackson White going deep to Gordon Lamb. He gets it. He's going to run it in for the touchdown. Cambridge after the pat leading 20-19. Then in the dying seconds of this game, less than a minute, Malik Cameron coming up with a big defensive stop. Not once, but twice. As we see here, Brampton going for the field goal in a rare play. Cameron blocking the field goal. Cambridge goes into the half leading 20-19. First play of the second half now. Brampton kicking that ball off to Cambridge. Although Cambridge can't really seem to hold on to that ball. Eventually picking it up is Jordan Russell of the Bulldogs. He'll run it in for the touchdown. Brampton scoring on the first play of both halves, now leading 26-20. Cambridge possession third quarter. Jackson White going deep to Devontae Hudson. Looks a lot like a play we've already seen from these two this game. Hudson finding the end zone yet again. Back and forth battle from these two teams. Cambridge now leading 27-20. Here on a run for the Bulldogs is number 5, Damar Ramsden, nephew of Canadian football great Michael Pinball Clemens. He was in attendance at this game. He gets the Bulldogs some good field possession. A couple plays later, Javonte Stanley going deep again to Kruma. Kruma makes the grab. He'll run it in. Brampton now leading 32-27. A few plays later, after Cambridge gives up a safety, Javonte Stanley, he is a natural running back in that Wildcat offense formation. He'll get away from the pack and gets away from that tackle, which is impressive. Runs it into the end zone. Brampton leads 41-27. Late fourth quarter, fourth down, Lions going for it. Jackson White to Lamb. They say that he did not make that catch, and he swears that he did. Big loss there for the Lions. So Cambridge turns the ball over to Brampton, and they go to work right away. Wildcat offense again. There goes Javonte Stanley. Dipping, ducking, diving, dodging through all kinds of bodies. Finds open field, and he's off to the races. He's going to run that one in. Brampton now leads 48-27. Late in the fourth quarter, just over a minute left, White finds Monahan in the end zone. That's good for a touchdown. Brampton leading 48-33. Then on the point after attempt, they block the field goal. Cambridge is not able to get a break here. 48-33 is your final score.
You've all heard it. You've seen the movie. any given Sunday. Anything can happen. And the truth is, they were the better football team tonight. Agreed? Special teams, offense and defense. They were better than we were. We expected to be better. We were not.
Missed all three sides of the football.
That's right. We gave the ball away. We really didn't need to, right? Listen, you guys didn't quit. You played tough. They had a better game plan and they stuck with it. Listen, I love you guys, man. I hate this. I really do. The end of the year and all that. And listen, I know. I know there's, you know. I'm sorry if I misled you to think that we're just going to get our way to the finals. I hope I didn't do that, but, you know, they were a damn good football team. And they stayed on the gas, but we couldn't. I love you guys. I appreciate your effort. It's been a great year. I know we already planned on moving our practice next week and all that. You know, I feel silly. But you know what? If it don't kill you, it's going to make you stronger. Okay? Like we talked about before the game, there's no piece of cake. Just because you look on the stat sheet and you think you're a better football team, it means nothing. They're over there celebrating and they deserve to. Doesn't mean we're not a good football team. I do believe we're a better football team. Unfortunately, we couldn't prove it tonight, and tonight was the night to do it. I love you guys. I love your efforts. And I love the fact that I got a whole pile of guys in front of me crying. That's, it shows that you care. It shows you love the sport. I think that's all I got. Yeah, that's it. Let's come in here and break down, okay? Aaron Hoyt, can you break us down?
As you saw, the junior varsity OVFL team did lose to the Brampton Bulldogs by a final score of 48-33. Also suffering a loss was our Bantam team to the Essex Ravens by a final score of 34-7. And winning an absolute thriller in Niagara was the Varsity Lions. 6 minutes left, Lions are winning by a score of 21-19. And then, with a minute 30 left, Niagara gets a touchdown to take the lead back. 25-21 at this point. Cambridge has got one last chance at this. Cambridge getting the touchdown with 8.3 seconds left to go ahead 28-25. That would be your final score. Unfortunately, we did not have highlights of this one before you. I really wish we did because it sounds like it was exciting. Simon Beeksma said that catch that got them that 28 score was one of the most important of his entire life. Definitely an exciting game. Cambridge, never having won a playoff game before, now wins two, and they will face off against Essex on Sunday. And as we did mention, Michael Pinball Clamp was at the junior varsity game. He did manage to get an interview with him. However, the audio editing here does need some work. I will publish it now. I did some minor editing. I will likely upload one in the future that has had some more editing to it. I'm warning you now in advance, the audio quality in this is quite difficult to hear. I really hope that we can get this cleaned up for you because Mr. Pinball did have some really great insight around the game of football, which I think are valuable for anybody to hear. So here it is.
So, Pinball Clemens, you're here at our game tonight, OV Conference Final, JV Conference Final, I should say. Lions facing off against the Brampton Bulldogs. You're here watching your nephew, Lamar Ramsden. What is it like here? It's exciting to see someone of your caliber out at our field. It's great to have you here. How's this game going so far for you as a fan?
For me, it's a huge delight to see these young guys play. I'm really thrilling, excited. It's so thrilling and thrilling to see them all in the new life. They're much better than we were. To see the level of execution here has been great. Just a great game. You see 20-19 at halftime. And I think they're looking forward to a great second half.
For sure. And now, obviously, you're a big advocate for growing the game at all levels. And as you mentioned, from what you've seen, it does appear to be going in that kind of direction. How do you think that can be improved? What are some next steps in terms of kids achieving that next level of excellence?
I think the big thing here is to get that mission well at an early age. Doing the little things, like having a little soft football for kids. Some people that we never want to do flag football, seeing the growth of flag football. Those are the kinds of things that we're learning about. When we get to these kids here, they want to play. There's others that would enjoy it every bit as much, but haven't been introduced to it. So I think it is being introduced to the game in different ways. Not just their tech football, but playing flag football. Introducing just catch on your line, soccer balls, bullish balls, and jumping balls. I think getting kids involved earlier, getting them to understand earlier, I think that's what makes the passion. For me, it's the best thing to do for kids, because no one person can take over. You've got a great player in hockey, if he's on the ice with six other guys, he can take over. Or another basketball guy on the court with five guys, he can take over that. But when you have a football game, the bonds that are created are so great in the game of football. So honestly, your kids get a chance to do it. And you really do find that kids, young people, young men, football, they can be all different sizes. You get oversized guys that feel awkward, uneasy about their weight, their size, and they begin to play football, and all of a sudden you see their level of confidence rise. You see their self-esteem rise. They have a place where they belong. So you can have the big guy and the small guy. Everybody's involved, and everybody has a place on the football field. So love, it's not for everybody, for certain, but that's okay. We love to see more people introduced.
First things first, I'm a realist.
Thank you so much for your insights. Thank you so much for your time today.
And I'm feeling the murder
beat. Thank you so much. And here's to a great second half. Congratulations to Cambridge for what's happened thus far. Great season to this
point.
What a real stand-up guy that Pinball Clemons is. Ask for an inch and he'll give you a mile. He really is a great guy. I asked him for a quick interview, and really one of the easier interviews I've had. I asked him a couple really short questions, and he went into some extreme detail there, so definitely making my job here much easier. So once again, thank you, Mr. Clemons. You will find that that audio is a little easier to listen to if you listen to it with headphones, just so you're eliminating some of the background noise which might be surrounding you. Once again, thank you for tuning in to another episode of The Lions Roar. It's really getting down to the wire here. Only one team left in action, the Varsity Lions, which means that we're at least going to have another episode of this show. So tune in on Sunday. Just a reminder that that game against Essex is on Kojiko TV, I believe. You may be able to link to that online. If so, I will tweet that out for you. Thanks for tuning in again, folks, and we'll see you here next time.